Good evening, everyone. This is Our Lady of Victory Church on North Avenue in Tallmadge, Ohio, broadcasting via FM radio 93.7, also live streaming via our parish Facebook page. We are about to begin the 5 p.m. Vigil Mass for the Solemnity of Mary, the Holy Mother of God. A reminder to anyone who may be praying with us from the parking lot, at the meantime, a minister will come out to the covered walkway to distribute communion to anyone praying with us from the parking lot. At that time, please come forward to receive communion and kindly return to your vehicle for the remainder of this celebration. For any unable to come forward, once those who are able have done so, then please drive out to the covered walkway, and a minister will bring communion to you while you're in your vehicle. Again, then simply return to your spot in the parking lot for the remainder of this celebration. Thank you, and we will begin shortly.
My friends, as was announced earlier today, Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI has died. He served as pontiff for about 8 years. And so, as the church begins officially 9 days of mourning, we are invited as part of that church to pray for the repose of his soul. And so I invite you at this time, before we begin this celebration, to join with me as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be, world without end. Amen. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Once again, good evening, everyone, and welcome. Please stand, and together we'll sing Angels We Have Heard on Top, and it's number 84. Hail, Holy Mother, who gave birth to the King, who rules heaven and earth forever.
And the mountains.
gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We come together on this festival of Mary, this festival that reminds us of our salvation, won for us by Christ. We call to mind then our sins as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christ Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Kyrie eleison. Mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. O God, who through the fruitful virginity of Blessed Mary bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her, through whom we were found worthy to receive the author of life, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Moses, speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, this is how you shall bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Among some of our Parish School of Religion catechists, I continue to hear about conversations that they've had with some of our youngest members regarding the movement, if you will, of the Bethlehem Star, as well as the nativity figures throughout the season of Advent. And for some of those figures, even into this season of Christmas, as evidenced by the Magi who are still traveling towards the creche. They've not yet arrived. With regard to our youngest members, they try to make it not only a competition, for example, where do you think the star will be this week, but also a catechetical lesson. In some ways, it elicits and stirs up that sense of wonder, something this season of Christmas is filled with, something that we are invited to be part of. While the intent of such movement is always to create an environment that reflected movement, it wasn't just about drawing our eyes and focus to the shrine setting of the Nativity. It was about a deep down recognition, at least in my own life, to pick up and move, go forward. Not remain stuck or so firmly planted in the what of the past or even the present, but rather the hope and the possibility of the unfolding of a future crafted by God. A future that's always new, always surprising, always calling me, always calling you, others, to go forward. Go forward glorifying and praising God for what God has done. But it's also a deep down recognition that ultimately God is birthed in our moving. Birthed in our moving away from something, albeit perhaps even a something that has certainly nourished and nurtured us. Something that's brought us comfort and security. Moving away, though, to the unknown that is to be birthed in and through us. Trusting that it's there that God will birth something new. It's there that light does illumine the darkness. It's there that life does come forth. Now you and I, friends, are in good company. Company to be trusted. For that's what we've been told time and time again throughout this holy season of Advent and well into this time of Christmas joy. We heard it from the prophet Isaiah. The people of Israel had gotten themselves in a rut. They were stuck. They'd been traveling in exile, but in that time they forgot about the God who had promised to be with them always and in all things, to save them from themselves, to send them a Messiah and King. But they needed to move forward away from their selfish ways, move forward away from their blindness, for in their movement, in their moving forward, they would be engaged in this long-awaited saving birth. We heard it from the mouth of John the Baptist, the one who was that prophetic voice crying out in the desert, calling others to prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his paths. John the Baptist, who others sought out, whom others moved toward, repenting of their ways, being baptized by him, so that grace might be born anew in them. And without a doubt, we experienced it in Mary, the mother of our Lord, who upon receiving incomprehensible and absolutely unbelievable news that she would in fact be the vessel through which God would join heaven and earth, through a son to be born to humankind, she did not sit idly by, but rather went in haste into the hill country to seek out her cousin Elizabeth, also with child, through God's making the impossible possible. We saw it in Joseph, a righteous man who took Mary into his home, trusting in what the angel had spoken to him in a dream, that despite the fact that Mary was with child, he was being called to pick up and move away from what others would have acted upon, based on the law of his day, so that this necessary saving birth could happen according to God's desire, according to God's plan. Shepherds left their flocks in the fields. Strangers from near and far gathered, for there was good news to behold, and because of that news, they would all experience the birth of something new, something good. And as the evangelist Luke reminds us in this night's gospel, when they saw this, they made known the message, told them about this child, giving birth to amazement by others who heard this same news. Amazement that changed the lives of others. Friends, the Advent and Christmas story has all been and continues to be about movement. Moving away from what has perhaps held us bound so that we might move forward and toward the very Lord himself. The Advent and Christmas story is the story and stuff of salvation. And any who hear it, any who believe it, cannot remain the same, but must be changed, must be different, must be open to giving birth to the life God has given humankind for the sake and benefit of others. Prophets did this. Shepherds did this. Joseph did this. And the one we honor this night, Mary, the mother of God, did this. All with great trust, deep faith, and certain hope in what God had promised would be fulfilled. May we heed God's call to go forth, to move in the days ahead, going forth from this very place, glorifying and praising God for all we have heard and seen. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Mary, as the perfect disciple, was faithful to God, trusting that God would provide. May our prayer be faithful as we seek God's grace and guidance for us and for all people.
For God's holy church, may it champion humankind's struggle for freedom from every slavery, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations, may they dedicate this new year to a more intensive search for peace, especially in the Ukraine, as well as portions of Africa and the Americas, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who seek a deeper meaning to their lives, may they find in Christ a teacher to follow and a purpose to live, especially those absent and missing from the body of Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who face new beginnings in the year ahead, may their courage and confidence be in God, whose face shines on them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, especially, John Chartarino, Bob Christian, Mary Downtown, Danny Firth, Mike Firth, Deja Furtney, Jeffrey Grismer, Dan Lane, Tom and Candy Lurkowski, Sister Mercia Madigan, Becky Mishler, Agnes Moran, Dora Katroki, Maggie Wright, Brooke Russell, Carol Scaley, Katrina Shunk, Paula Simmons, John Von Gutten, Bob Wakeman, Lou Wells, Clara Whitus, Bishop Woost. For those who struggle with mental illness and for the victims and survivors of clergy sexual abuse in our church, may they find comfort in the prayer and support of this community of faith and those who care for them daily, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of faith throughout this coming year, may our love of God be ever more passionate, our love of others be ever more sincere, and our work at becoming and making disciples be ever more fruitful, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who were named as God's own in this life, especially those who have recently died, Phyllis Jurek, sister of Nancy Weiss, Robert McNeil, husband of Catherine, and Mary Matus, for whom this Mass is offered, along with all our beloved dead. May the Lord lift up his countenance on them now and give them peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI, called to the heavenly kingdom by the Lord, may rejoice forever at the eternal banquet, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers that remain in the silence of our hearts and minds, for those written in our prayer notes book, and for those we have been asked to pray for through our renewal recommitment initiative, may we be confident that God does indeed provide for our every need. we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, the maker of each year's dawning, the guardian of its unfolding days, and the crown of its appointed end, yours is the name invoked upon us. Yours the Son, born to us of a woman. Yours the Spirit, poured forth into our hearts. Bless and keep in this new year all who cry out to you, Abba. Make your face to shine on all whom you have adopted in Mary's Son. Lift up your countenance, and in the power of your Spirit, give us peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, Emmanuel, God with us, your Son who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory chant will sing together Lo, How a Rose Hair Blooming, and it's number 92. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise of the Lord and his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who in your kindness begin all good things and bring them to fulfillment, grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginnings of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the solemnity of the motherhood of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. The whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death. For you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time, you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior, made incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death. And rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, free from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. chant, let's sing together, "O Come, All Ye Faithful," and it's number 93.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life. For we rejoice to proclaim the blessed ever Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for a few moments. Once again, we continue to look back over the year and look back over just this season and thank those who give of their time and their talent to support your parish's mission and ministry. Also to those who give up treasure to support that mission and ministry as well. Envelope users do remember the collection boxes at the entrance of the church. This evening, because we're going to move into Exposition of the Blessed Sacrament, the bulletins will not necessarily be handed out. They'll be on tables near the entrance of the church, along with the most holy calendars that will be there in a few moments. Please, we do ask for the calendars, one per household, and if, of course, if you know of a shut-in, please take them one. And once we know that everybody who has wanted one got one, then it's up for grabs. Do remember that January 9th, the Feast of the Baptism of the Lord, we will have the presence of the first-class relics for Blessed Carlo Acutis and St. Manuel Gonzalez Garcia, along with all-day exposition of the Blessed Sacrament. There are sign-up sheets on tables near the entrances of the church. Please, please, please do sign up. We need to ensure that there is coverage throughout the day, and it just will be a very prayerful day, so we encourage you to be part of that. We will close, we open with Mass that morning, and then we will close that night with evening prayer at 7 p.m. The Parish Center offices will be closed in observance of New Year's on Monday, January 2nd. Again, the Holy Hour will follow this celebration in a moment. And to each and every one of you, I extend on behalf of the parish staff the choicest of blessings in the coming year. I'm certain there have been joys for each one of us and pains for each one of us, but in all of that, God's been present, and that's the good news. God remains present. As you heard at the beginning or prior to the start of the celebration, Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI died this morning, so there are a few details that we have to communicate via announcement. First of all, the funeral mass for Pope Emeritus will be celebrated Thursday, January 5th at the Vatican, and that will be presided over by Pope Francis. Retired Bishop Martin Amos will celebrate a memorial mass at the Cathedral of St. John the Evangelist this coming Thursday, January 5th at 12 noon, and this is open to the public. It will most likely also be live streamed, so you can check out the diocesan website for that. We will be celebrating a memorial mass for Pope Emeritus here at Our Lady of Victory this Wednesday evening, January 4th at 7 p.m. The change in the schedule will be that there's not going to be exposition and evening prayer that evening. Rather, there will be a memorial mass for Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI. All certainly are encouraged to participate. For any who are liturgical ministries, if you are able to minister that evening, please do let us know as soon as possible. This will not replace the already scheduled Mass for Wednesday morning at 8:30 a.m. That will remain in place. The official mourning period will most likely be for 9 days, and all are encouraged to pray for the repose of the soul of Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI during that time, offering an Our Father, a Hail Mary, a Glory Be, as well as praying the rosary for his intention. So thank you very much. My friends, our lives are made of days and nights, of seasons and years, for we're part of a universe of suns and moons and planets. We mark ends and we make beginnings, and in all we praise God for the grace and mercy that fill our lives. Let us now pray for God's blessing on us and on the days ahead in this coming year. Remember us, O God, from age to age, be our comforter. You have given us the wonder of time, blessing in days and nights, seasons and years. Bless us in the days ahead at the turning of the year, and fill the months ahead with the bright hope that is ours in the coming of Christ. You are our God, living and reigning forever and ever.
Amen.
And I need three individuals.
We'd like to sing a hymn, the words, "Stay with us, O Lord, for the day will soon be over. Stay within us, O light of the world. When you are near, the night becomes day."
Amen.
comes day.
Ever faithful God, in the gift of your only Son given to us by a woman, as we celebrate the motherhood of your daughter Mary this night, we give you thanks and praise for the gift that remains with us, the gift of him in the Blessed Sacrament. Lord, be with us in the turning of the year. In our sadness, bring our comfort. In our joy, celebrate well with us. And in all we do, help draw us closer to him, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
In our gather books, I invite you to sing of the Father's love begotten, and it's number 86 in our Breaking Bread books. Number 86.
Creation praise.